All right. Something you've all been waiting for. How to stop procrastinating once and for all. I've been meaning to tell you about this, but I've been putting it off. Hey, do you constantly put off tasks? Do you create excuses for why you'll do something later than right now? If this sounds like you, then you know a thing or two about procrastinating. It's an issue most of us deal with every single day. We were wondering if there was a way to stop procrastinating and get on with life. Let's try to find an answer to this question together. But before we start, not to put it off too long, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Turn on notifications too. Now you won't miss any of our new videos. Alright, we all have our share of important things to do. Studying for a test, completing a work project, or doing household chores. But we keep telling ourselves that we'll do it after we finish this or that, and we never follow the plan. So why do we procrastinate? Where does this desire to put stuff off come from? According to Joseph Ferrari, PhD, and Timothy Peichel, PhD, leading experts on procrastination, procrastinators are made, not born. Experts suggest that it comes from an authoritarian parenting style, either because the child loses the ability to take care of themselves, or as a form of rebellion. Ferrari identifies three basic types of procrastinators. The first are people who love the thrill of doing everything at the last minute. The second group is afraid of failure or success, as they're scared of other people's opinions. The last group can't make decisions or take responsibility for the consequences that come with them. So, the lifetime cure for procrastination isn't that hard to find. You have to figure out which group you're in and deal with the reason connected to it. For example, the motive behind procrastination for people in the second group is their low self-esteem. If they work on it, it'll become much easier for them to get things done. The third group has to level up their responsibility, and then procrastination won't be a big problem anymore. The only ones who might find it tricky to get out of this procrastination cycle belong to the first group. They enjoy the fear and thrill of doing everything at the last minute, and it is harder to erase this inner desire. However, none of these solutions are instant. They require serious and dedicated psychological work. So, are there any other ways to deal with procrastination right now and make it go away? At least for the little bit when it's really necessary? Of course there are! Hey, let's talk about this tomorrow. Now wait, let's do it now. Listen up! Counting down from number 7. Change your environment. Your work environment is very important. The more distractions there are, the fewer chances you have of getting anything done. You can find lots of apps to help you block any possible distractions from your phone for a certain period of time. It's hard to get something done when you're constantly getting notifications from Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube, right? The same goes for your laptop. Changing your workspace can also be the answer to conquering procrastination. It shouldn't be just cute or cool. It should inspire you to get things done. When you're a procrastinator, the hardest thing is to get started. When you overcome this hurdle, it gets easier and easier as you have all the skills to move forward to the very end. The appropriate atmosphere can help you take this first step. Number 6. Break your tasks into small pieces. Have you heard this one? How do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. If the thought of doing a major task is overwhelming, try to break it into a couple of smaller ones. For example, if you have to write a long paper or do a big project, write down a list of all the things you need to do from the moment you sit down to write to the moment it's done. Then follow this plan task by task. It may be hard at first, but the more you get into it, the easier it'll be. Complete all your tasks and get it done. Number 5. Use the 15-minute rule. It's hard to convince yourself to complete a task right away, but can you do just 15 minutes? It doesn't seem like a long period of time, right? And that's how the 15-minute rule was born. To see whether this method will work for you, grab a timer, set it for 15 minutes, and start working. Once you begin, you'll get into it and forget about the time frames. Take our word for it, it's no wonder this technique is so popular. People usually end up doing this first bit of work for much more than 15 minutes. However, if you can only deal with 15 minutes, take a 15-minute break before continuing to work for another 15 minutes. Then repeat this work-rest-work-rest pattern. This simple work method will help you get more and more involved and finally finish the task. Number 4. Start with the hardest thing. It's like that old saying, if you have to swallow some frogs, start with the biggest one first. Yuck. But true. The logic behind this is very simple. Pick the hardest task on your list and do it first. The most difficult task is usually the one you'll procrastinate about the most. So when it's done, you'll not only feel relieved, but realize how easy it'll be now to do everything else. Using this method will give you the strength to get everything done quickly and efficiently. Plus, the hardest tasks often only seem this way, but when you start to work on them, they're not as bad as you expected. So make it a rule to do the scariest thing right away, and then enjoy all the other easy parts afterward. Number 3. Reward yourself. If you can't even imagine sitting for hours working on a task, space it out a little bit. If you have to study for a test, review one question, and then watch one YouTube video or 10 minutes of your favorite TV show. Then repeat the question you learned, learn the second one, watch another video for another 10 minutes of the show, and so on. This little reward system will not only help you relax between working, but will also give you something to look forward to after completing each part of your work. Don't cheat, and be strict with yourself by setting rules. You don't want to end up having a YouTube binge session. With a little willpower, this method will make it easier for you to get everything done. Number 2. Hang out with inspiring people more often. Your friends and acquaintances can also make a huge difference to your procrastinating. When you surround yourself with driven and inspiring people, you want to do more to work towards your dreams. On the other hand, if most of your friends are lazy, you'll see no problem in delaying everything for no reason. The people we spend time with influence us greatly. The more time you spend with go-getters, the more ambitious and determined you'll become. One more reason to pick the people you surround yourself with wisely, right? Watching interviews with legendary people can also give you a necessary dose of inspiration. Number 1. Try time management. Time management requires you to make a list of everything you have to do and write down exactly when you'll do it. It's incredibly helpful for those in the world of business and pretty much everyone else. And procrastinators are no exception. Specialists say that the best way to manage your time is to write down everything from your tasks to your daily routines, like brushing your teeth or even watching your favorite TV show. Of course, life will make its changes, but you'll still have a plan. Using different time management techniques will make you more organized and responsible. When everything is set up, not doing one thing can ruin your whole plan for the day. You definitely won't want to do that when you've come this far. So try to organize your time at least for a couple of days in advance. Chances are, you won't be disappointed. Don't forget that the sooner you start to battle your procrastination, the better. As Victor Khayyam used to say, procrastination is opportunity's assassin. Moreover, research has confirmed that students who procrastinated during their academic term lowered their immune system's protection, developing way more colds, gastrointestinal problems, and even insomnia. Procrastination can also ruin your social relationships and destroy team projects. Conquering procrastination, on the other hand, will not only help you start afresh in lots of areas in your life, but will also make you much healthier. So, why not start right now? As time management expert Mary Poppins said, "Well begun is half done." So, do you have any tips of your own on how to stop procrastinating? Tell us in the comments below. Don't forget to give us a like and click subscribe to stay on the bright side of life. Do it now.